You're having your window cleaned, monkey. Is the window cleaner cleaning your window? What's happening? Excuse the messy room. What's happening? So today I am going into town this afternoon with Dee, and I'm going to try and film bits. I'm not sure if I'll film things because I kind of want to just focus on the day, but I'll see. There'll be a few things that I can film this week, so I'm going to try and get a few bits done. And also, as I've not said it yet, welcome to weekly vlog number 3, and I hope you enjoy the vlog. So it is Tuesday morning, and it is 5 to 8. We are up and ready for the nursery run. I just need to get her shoes on and everything. And you're being a little monkey this morning, aren't you? What the frick? So it is a Tuesday morning. It's 5 to 8. Got a bit of a moody little lady this morning, which is no surprise. She tends to be moody on nursery mornings because it seems to be a theme. I don't know why. But this little one's ready for nursery run. Just need to do shoes and a coat. I don't tend to put her in the clothes that I normally put her in for nursery. I put her in ones that it's not like a huge deal if they get wrecked and that. So you tend to see her in more like a different style of clothes sometimes for nursery. What's wrong? Oh. Mia, come sit on my knee. When she's at nursery, I'm going to have a day of cleaning my room and things. I think I may go back to bed when she's gone to nursery, because I just went to bed too late and it was my own fault. But yeah, I might do that. And then just get jobs done. I'm washing. Hopefully this little one will go easily today.
No.
What? What's wrong? Sorry, you want me to be this way, do you? Sorry. I kind of look like death today. Why? Mummy's vlogging, you little monkey. I do look like death today. I feel like it as well. It's not good, is it? Does Mummy look like death today?
Oh.
But yes, we are hopefully going to have a good drop off, because I hate it when we have difficult drop offs. You're going to go play with your friends at nursery? Yes, you are. But yes, I think that's all I have to update you on. And hopefully, I actually come back, get the couple jobs that I need to, have the sleep and feel more rejuvenated to do the rest of the jobs, because I really need to get them done. What do you think? Do you think it's going to happen?
No.
Oh, that's brilliant. You have so much faith in me. Thanks. I will see you guys soon. So it is 9:15 on a Tuesday night, and I'm laying in bed, fully closed, with lots of things still to do, which is not good. I'm really annoyed. For some reason, this camera is being dodgy. So right now, I may be really whited out by my laptop. But yeah, I keep turning it on and the screen's black, which is really annoying because I really cannot be getting a new camera at the moment. Like, I seriously can't afford it. I struggle enough already with that. Things like that getting in the way. Yeah, I'm very, very tired. Hello. Why am I so tired? I shouldn't be. But it's the problem with me. I seem to be like a sloth. If anything, I can't compare myself to a sloth. I just want to sleep, or a koala even. Koala all day. I just want to sleep. I'm laying in bed watching Holly Samantha's weekly vlog, trying to get some inspiration to keep myself going with the weekly vlog because it's just been so bad lately and I hate it. And I've noticed as well, since getting the implant, it won't be completely the implant's fault, and part of it is me, most likely. But since getting the implant, I've put weight on really easily. It just really annoys me. It really kind of sets me back on where I am. But pushing through it, just kind of gotta be more careful. I may get it taken out and change what I'm on because I don't know if I like the fact that that's one of the effects, but yeah, I'll wait and see. Ebony went to bed early today, picked her up from nursery, and she was shattered, completely done. She was completely done for the day, and she was in a mood, so I put her to bed like a bit before 7:30, I think. And I went to Dee's for a bit earlier. Keep meaning to take my camera around and film around there. And I just forget. So maybe at some point it'll happen. Maybe I'll actually get around to it. I need to do the fire. I need to tidy up downstairs. Could have done with it in my ironing tonight, but I think I find my ironing such a pain that I might hang stuff up and iron things as I need them, because some things I iron and I end up not wearing them for ages, and then I'm really frustrated that I ironed them because I'm just like wasting so much time when I could have been doing something else. But I'm trying to get the energy to go to bed, do some stuff. I literally look like death today. Feel and look like death. Like, that's why I've got such big bags under my eyes today. May as well be prouder. I wish. Yeah, I'm kind of trembling, but I'm trying to weigh up the pros and cons to get out of bed. The only problem is there's so many cons, there's not really many pros, but one of the main pros is getting a cup of tea. So I'm trying to focus on that, and then I can get up when the jobs are done and that, I can go back upstairs and lie back in bed and maybe try and sleep a lot earlier today, because last night was not such a success. So that's basically what's going on today. Can't think of anything else. Yeah, hopefully I managed to get out of bed. If not, we will be going very cold tonight and the fire will not keep going. So I have been to town today. It's Wednesday, it's 2:30. Literally just gotten back and just gotten Ebony into bed. And I got a couple things in town, so I wanted to do a haul / first impressions. So the thing I got, which I have gotten before and actually constantly use at the minute, is the Tanya Bear Cosmetics Perfect Brows Kit. So I have been using this for about a year, going on a year. I think the last year my brow game has definitely changed, I'm going stronger, thank God. This is what it looks like inside. I tend to use them two colours. At the minute I'm going for that one more, which is chestnut. Sometimes I go for the darker one, which is hot cocoa, and sometimes I go for a mix. But it's really good. The applicator inside is pretty good, but I tend to use the MAC 263. I think it's 263, I may be wrong. But it's the thinnest angle brush of the angle brushes MAC do. And the tweezers are really good. I use these the tweezers in here to put my eyelashes on all the time, and they're perfect for that. So yeah, I'm glad that I got that, because my one, I've hit pan and hot cocoa, and I'm not far hitting pan or chestnut, so it was needed, and at least I've got one in stock then. Also from the Tiny Burr range, which I've been trying to get my hands on for a while since it's come out, is the one of the lipsticks in hot cocoa. I actually have it on now. Could do with a bit of topping up actually, if anything. And it's a beautiful, like, let me show you. It is a beautiful kind of nudie pink. Well, it's pinky brown, but it is quite nude. And it's a very pretty shade. It goes on quite pink on my lips, actually. But I think that may be my skin colour and skin tone. Well, I find that most lipsticks do go on differently on everyone. But I really like it. It's a really pretty colour and a nice shade. So I am glad I was able to get hold of that. The next one is Zoella. I have been using her, I think it's called Scrubbing Me Softly body scrub from the, I can't remember what the range was called, the Tutti Frutti range, for quite a while, because I get very, like, I get bad skin and it gets very dry and can build up very thick quickly and get really uncomfortable, and like it's not nice at all. I have a serious problem with it sometimes, so I constantly have to keep on top of that with a harsh scrub, and the only scrub that has met that standard is that one, but that has now been discontinued and replaced with her pretty polished sugar scrub in her main line. But I decided to get this one instead and give it a try. I'm hoping it's a really similar formula, because it really is perfect for me, and it is a sugar scrub. It's not meant to be really used as a face scrub, I don't think, but it doesn't say not to. The description says, buff your skin beautiful with gorgeously scented sugar scrub. Massage into wet skin, then rinse well to reveal super smooth skin. Scrubbly jubbly. So, it doesn't say that it's not meant to be used as a skin scrub, but that is what I use it as. And the last thing I got is the PS Pro Non-Latex Mini Blenders, which is the Primark Mini Beauty Blenders. I have seen Holly Samantha review the mini ones. I'm not entirely sure if these are the exact same, but they're the only ones I could get. So I thought I'd give them a go, because they're affordable as well. And as you see, at the minute I've got like a bit of print from wearing eyeliner. I get it very easily with my eye shape. It's very easy for me to get. So I want to do a bit of an impressions while I am here. I think I'll use one of the black ones first. I like the texture, the really, like, movable. I can't think of the word. They're easy to move around, and they're not too firm, but they're also not too soft. I normally go with, this is very, very grubby, but with the Real Techniques Miracle Complexion Sponge. I need to get some new ones because mine are very grubby, and I know it's really, really bad, but I really don't have the time and money to constantly wash them, because it takes me a long time, and I don't have the money to replace them much. But either way, I'm going to try this one out. So I'm going to put a bit of concealer under my eyes, because I get creases under my eyes where I smile as well. So as you can see, when I smile, I get creases there, and it is very irritating. But this I think will be a perfect size to take on the go with you, definitely. And it will make it a lot easier to apply under the eye, because when I use the bigger brushes, not brushes, sponges, I have a really bad problem with trying to not mess up the makeup I've done so far. That has applied quite nicely. It's not completely got rid of my mess under there, but I'm not hugely bothered about that. That is partially because I haven't actually taken it off before putting it on. But I think that it's quite good. It applies nicely, applies really evenly. I'm happy with that. That'll be nice to use, definitely. I'll do the other eye, just for the fact that that needs doing too. But yeah, I went into town with Dee and the kids today. I'm going around to hers later on. Ebony is going to her nanny soon. She's just gone down for a sleep just before her nanny comes, because she's going to be exhausted, because we were in town till about a bit past two. So it was a while, and she's very, very tired now and worn out. But I'd kind of prefer that. See, I have a feeling it's going to be good on blemishes as well. I do get breakouts a lot. I just kind of find ways to cover them up as best I can. And I think this might help with that. I'm pretty happy with that though. I'm happy with that coverage. Try it down the bridge of nose, because I would like to use it down the bridge of nose, and that bit's coming off as well, which really infuriates me. And what also is annoying me at the minute is my camera. I'm still having problems with it. Before filming this clip, I had to restart it about four times to actually get the screen to work. So that really isn't brilliant. So I might try and take it in somewhere and see if someone can fix it, because I can't afford to be getting a new camera. But yeah, that's applied really nicely. And I don't know how well you can see, but I'm pretty happy with that. I'm glad that I got these. And they're definitely a travel size. So if you needed one, instead of taking like one of the big beauty blenders like this, you can take a tiny one and it'll be so much easier. I also don't wet beauty blenders before I use them, really, because it works better on my skin, dry, and I think that might just be my skin type, but it does, so that's what I tend to do. But yeah, I'm looking forward to use these more when I do my makeup from scratch, and then I'll try and remember to let you know how they do then as well. I don't know if this is going to film, because the stupid camera screen has broken and it's just topped off a day that is not going too well for me already. So far I've not had the best day. It took me ages to do my makeup as well, which really frustrated me, and it's just not been a good day. So I'm not in the happiest of moods, which is not what I want at all. Really isn't. I'm doing myself some lunch. I just put Abby down to bed, and it's just not going as dandy as I would have hoped today would have gone. I'm gonna have to check on my laptop to see if it still records and if this bloody camera is screwed or not. I really hope it's not. Abby is in bed, literally the camera right now, the back of it is blank, which is really fucking annoying. I'm gonna go and have some lunch and try and calm down. So I need to update you guys. The vlog camera that I use, the Canon S110, has not always been working. The actual screen, like not that bit there, but the bit behind that I can see, hasn't always been turning on, and it's a huge problem. I'm not completely sure how long this camera's going to last. I'm gonna try and go and get it seen to, because I cannot afford a new one. But if I can't get it sorted, I may not be able to vlog for a while, which actually really annoys me, because I miss out as well as you guys missing out. But I will try and get it fixed. I'm really thankful that it's actually turned on. I've been trying all day to get this to turn on. And also, we've just been to the pharmacy because Ebony has conjunctivitis, so we've got eye drops for that. But tonight I'm going around to Dee's, and we're going to have a few drinks and some fun. I'll try and take my camera, try and film. With any luck, I will be able to film there and remember to film there. But yeah, so if there's not much footage, I'm really sorry. This camera is screwed. And I hope you guys understand. So, it is tea time. Sorting tea. I'm going to sugar up on this camera while I open the door. We are just watching my baby video. Can you get down off there, Ebony? That's a really silly move, isn't it?
No.
Get down. We're watching my baby video. I'm about to touch up my makeup because it's smudged a bit. Can you get down, please? That's my grandma who passed away almost 2 years ago. Makes her quite nostalgic. That's me and my sister. Is that me and Auntie Emily? Yeah? Down off there, please, honey. No, we're not to stand up there. But yeah, I'm going to touch up my makeup and might make it into a bit of a montage. So it's nice to have a good montage. My camera turned on first time this time, which I'm really, really relieved about. But yeah, it's not been doing that every time, so I'm going to film a bit of a montage of me redoing my makeup, and I hope that it works out. There's a channel, I can't remember what it's called. Actually, it's coming up with my suggestions because she's on my YouTube. It's called it's called Dave and Ava. Nursery Rhymes and Baby Songs. She absolutely loves their videos. And from them, she's learned some new colours. And she can count up to 10 and she can remember it. She can go 1 to 10. In the right order, and she retains the information. I didn't end up filming last night. Me and Dee did go out for a bit. We decided to go out, and then we came back. I got home about 1 and went straight to bed. And then me and Abby woke up at 7, and even though I didn't have that much sleep compared to what I would, I'm not that tired. And I'm glad to be home with my little lady. It's a bit of a rubbish weather day, so I'm going to have a chill day with her. In 2 minds about doing washing today while she's here, or tomorrow while she's at her nanny's. Because I know I will be resting up tomorrow while she's at her nanny's because I can feel myself getting ill again. But washing isn't that much of a strain. It's just the ironing, which is a bit of a ball ache, but it's not a huge problem. So yeah, I'm not sure yet, but I wanted to show you that because I think it's really cute, and it just amazed me how much she's growing, and it's a wonderful thing. It makes me very happy, makes my heart happy. I'm sorry I look like this because I wore my makeup. I put my makeup on about lunchtime. Finished putting makeup on about lunchtime. So from lunchtime to about 1 a.m, I wore my makeup. So for a solid like, what would it be? Like over 13 hours, I wore my makeup. So the sides of my eyes are really sore because they get the most sensitive when I have makeup on. It's when my eczema flares up the most on my face and across here. But that seems to have been okay recently for the last few months. But yeah, my eyes go really red because they get very tired and strained. It gets towards the evening that I have to wear my glasses generally. Sometimes in the day, it depends on my eyes on the day, but when I'm on nights out, I don't wear my glasses out, obviously, and I don't wear contacts because I don't really need them, so my eyes go really red on nights out. Fun fact about me, it's a nightmare, it's really annoying, but yeah, I'm going to go. I'm just watching Anna's Coney's What's in My Hospital Bag, and I'll try and get some more cute bits of Ebony because I absolutely love looking back at these. So it's later in the evening, it's 6:22. I've had a little lady bath. She has not slept all day. So what I thought would be a really nice sweet day has not been. But I've started put the top light on so you can see better. Started putting like natural Moroccan argan oils in her hair, and stand still, babe. Mummy needs to see your hair, hon. And that's the best I'm gonna be able to. There we go. Look at how curly it's been going. It's so curly, and I absolutely love it. It's the cutest thing ever. I've been doing that because her hair gets very knotty. I know mine did when I was young. Mine was very fine and very straight, but because hers is a bit thicker and it's curly as well, it's just not as easy. It gets really knotty and she ends up in tears when I'm brushing it out. I'm currently doing a roast, and it's all good. I am glad to be doing a roast. It's one of the few things I do really like cooking, and it's just nice to have in the last for a while as well. You have leftovers for a while. Also watching the Kardashians. Bit sad because it's the season finale, and I don't know when the next season comes out on Hayu yet. So I need to have a look at that. But yes, I thought I would update you, and I had to show you the curls because they're absolutely adorable. So it is Sunday morning, it is 9:50. Ebony's going to her nanny's, which is going a bit later today, so she's just in the front room kind of chilling. I'm letting her chill in her pyjamas for a while. I am watching Louise Pentland's weekly vlog, and embracing looking a complete mess today because I'm not doing anything else. I'm just gonna have a bit of a day in. I think I may go and have a lie down after she's gone, as we were up at 6 in the morning. She was up in the night with nightmares and I didn't get to sleep till about midnight. Yeah, it was a bit past midnight because I got reading and got very distracted. But yes, I'm gonna have a really chilled day, and just take it easy. I've got a couple loads of washing to do, but if I spread it out throughout the day, it's not a huge problem. But I'm very, very tired. I I'm not too bad. I'm managing, but I'm definitely going for a rest when she goes. She goes in 2.5 hours, and it is a bit of a countdown, which may sound mean to some people, but I sometimes get to this point where I'm very tired. They don't have her every weekend, it's every other weekend. So when I do get the full day break, it's needed, because a lot of the time when she naps, either I nap with her and she doesn't nap for long, or I don't get to nap because I've got to sort out. And as a person, I just get really fatigued very easily. But yeah, she is watching some Dave and Ava videos in the front room and eating a dip. She's made a complete mess, and that's all the stuff I have to sort. So it does not look brilliant right now. A wipe, and it's a bit of a nightmare, but it's one of those days. I've just realised I've been putting the camera down. Brilliant. I'm doing great today. Right, okay. I'm going to turn this clip. I'm rambling. I need to shut up. So I've just done Little Lady some lunch. We went up to the spa, didn't we? We went up to the shop. We got her some yummy lunch. She got ham sandwich. She got hummus dip and breadsticks and some French fries, some Worcester sauce French fries, because they seem to be her favourite at the minute. She does go through a phase of changing. But she's having lunch early, and I'm going to sort out and then have my lunch. And yeah, it's a nice day. She's doing really well as well, so hopefully she'll actually eat all of this up. So I'm going to end the weekly vlog here. It's quite late in the evening. I literally just relaxed all day, didn't do much. I just took some time out to kind of chill. Got one load of washing sorted, the other I'm going to do tomorrow. And just had a bit of a relaxed day because it was well needed. It was definitely needed. So took that opportunity while I had it, and yeah, she came back in a happy mood. I filmed a little clip of her watching those videos that I was telling you about that she watches and loves. I'm going to probably go upstairs, catch up on YouTube videos, and edit now. Have my cup of tea waiting for me. But yes, I hope you enjoyed the vlog. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And subscribe if you aren't new, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.